Everyone, I'm glad that you have stopped by to watch my first ever official video with all of this. Look at it. Better just check the teeth, because we all know what happens there. So if you want to see how I went from being my normal beautiful self to this beautiful self, keep watching and enjoy. Here I am again without makeup. But for now, I'm just gonna get going, because you can keep waiting for the perfect opportunity to come up and you'll just end up waiting and waiting and waiting. Nothing is ever right. I was like, my nails are gonna be perfect for this. I have to do my nails for this. But I had to cut them because I'm trying to play guitar. I can't play guitar. But the point is, I'm trying. I won't give up, no I won't give. I'm getting better, but the point is I can't have nice nails to try and play guitar, so sacrifices have to be made. First I'm going to start with this Bella V Primer Moisturiser. I have already cleansed, exfoliated, toned and moisturised my skin, and put a bit of hydrating gel around here for those dehydrated lines, but my skin still feels a little bit, it just needs a bit extra, and plus being a primer too, it is going to help. The makeup stay on. Should I do that thing? Just a little bit. Hold the phone, where's the music? Put it everywhere. Let's just turn you down a little bit. Oh! Just dropped my guitar! I've got lovely skin, but there are problems with my skin. Now I'm gonna do something that's a little bit embarrassing, but Lord knows I'm past being embarrassed now. Let's just go up close, shall we? Zoom. There you go, look at that. So there we go, now you've seen a lot of me. I don't mind the breakouts so much. I'm actually working on them at the moment because a lot of my problems are a result of the food that I've been eating for the last 6 months / 10 years. Sugar does not agree with me. I'm sure it does not agree with a lot of you either, and we're always very quick to say, let's just have a block of chocolate. This is what happens. Mine happens within hours or overnight. I use really, really good skincare. I know that my actual skin feels really good, like the tone of it is good. It's nice and supple, but I have all this and I'm currently working on it with another beauty therapist, and I will have another video in a few months to show you guys the process of detoxifying myself and getting it to a much better state. But this is reality, okay? I'm gonna be honest with you guys when it comes to nails, skin, fashion, hair. I keep getting distracted by the music. Now that I've gone and put that on, I feel like my pores are a little bit, hang on, let me show you. Surprise! Can you see my pores just here? Now I've got some pores here that need sorting out because they are quite visible and I don't want my makeup to be all holy on my face. So I'm just gonna apply another primer. Yes, another primer. This is from Dearstry Naturals. It's very good for wrinkles as well. It keeps your makeup from settling into them. And I'm going to put a little bit on there and you'll see that they just close all the pores, they just suck them up. If you put too much on though, it's very watery and it will dry like a flaky mess on your face. Okay, now we're all ready. Most of the products that I'm going to be using are Bella V, which is a New Zealand created product. So unless I state otherwise, you can assume whatever I'm using is from Bella V. I'm going to start with concealer. It only comes in two colours, it looks like that. Mine's very well used. This one is light medium, and I'm going to start by putting it under my eye, just patting it, not and any areas that I need extra coverage, which is basically this whole section here. just push it into your little eye cracks. I like to put it up in here too, because that's quite dark for me in there. It'll just brighten it up a bit. When I use different brands of makeup, I'll quite often apply concealer after my foundation. As foundation, by the time you've got it on, you find that you've covered up a lot already and you don't need much concealer. But with Bella V, it seems like it blends a lot nicer. You get a better overall finished product when you conceal first. It is a good idea to use a brush to put them on too, but does it really matter at the end of the day? Now I'm going to start applying my loose mineral foundation. It blends and melts into your face. The packaging is beautiful, look at it. When you're dealing with minerals, they come loose like that. You just have to dab some onto the brush, get it even, tap off the excess, and then just start buffing that stuff onto your skin. Typically as well with oilier skin types, you can be more prone to oxidization, which is when your foundation slowly turns orange or darker throughout the day due to a reaction with the oils on your face. This happens to me a lot and it is so annoying. I've tried so many foundations and a lot of them do it. It really depends on my skin on the day. It's really hard to when you're quite a pasty sort of yellow, half Filipino skin tone, to get a good balance of pinks and yellows and all that, and then to finally have one and then have it go darker. It's just so annoying. You just keep on going until you've got the desired coverage that you want. And don't forget to get it close to your hairline. Oh, how could I do it again? You'd think I would have learnt by now. And you just keep building up and building up and building up. Less is definitely more for me, but depending on what kind of mood you're in, I can do a heavy full coverage. Halfway through that, I've realised that my eyebrows need to be tidied up, but I did promise myself that I would present myself to you in all of my glory, so here it is. Do you know what? I don't even care. I'm just going to leave them. Now that my foundation's on, I'm going to go in with a setting powder. You don't often need to use a setting powder with the loose mineral foundation, but personally I like it just to have that extra assurance that I'm not going to shine up as much as I normally would. Same sort of thing. Nice big fluffy brush. And I'm just going to dab it wherever I need it, which is basically right through my T-zone. Double check that we got all the bits and pieces. I see you undercut. Bella V also have this pressed foundation, which comes in the same colours as the loose and the liquid, which is great because you can take it out with you and then just touch up like that. Actually, I'm going to put some on just to give me a bit more coverage here. Dab, dab, dab. Don't spread it around and muck up all your hard work. I'm going to do a tiny, tiny little bit of contouring, but not hard out contouring, just enough to give my face just a little bit more accentuation, nothing too heavy. With this I'm using a blush shade in Bella V called Rosewood. I'm going to make sure there's very little on the actual brush and literally just put the tiniest bit right into my sideburns there, just enough to create a little bit of depth, but that's all. See, don't go any further. So I just had this song on my phone because the children really like it. My foot may or may not be starting to tap uncontrollably. Fly, they fall down and get up. Oh look, see, little bit stripy, dandy. Oh, I won't give in till I reach the end and then I'll start again. It's pretty much the story of my makeup life. So when you want to fix something like that up, this is the foundation brush. I'm just going to soften it a little bit. Here we go. Not so bad now, is it? Try everything! Okay, what I've got now is a bit of Stardust Bronzer, which is a beautiful, beautiful bronzy shade. And we're just going to lightly put it sort of all over just to, because we love it. It's just going to warm our face up. Not that I need any more warm, eh? Yellow skin. Okay, I haven't really gone and put it everywhere. I just had the tiniest bit on my brush and I like to just surround the face with it. Kind of like where the sun would hit. Try everything! I feel like I should come clean with you guys and tell you that I did love that song. So here I've got the foundation of my face laid. Now I'm ready to go on with the look. And then I will come back and add a bit more cheek colour. Just bring it all up to the same sort of thing. Oh yes, with the music! Now I'm going to put some primer on my lids. It's called Density Cream and it is quite a thick thing. So you don't really need too much, otherwise you end up with like a tacky situation going on up here. But I'm just going to dab it all over. It will take the colour right out of your lids as well, which is really good. If you have hooded eyelids like me, or excess skin like me, it is coming. Look, you'll get, you've hardly got anything there, wait till you're 50. Well, I know, wait till I'm 50, they're gonna be hanging off my face. Just be aware that I'm gonna do some really cool sort of hooded eye makeup tutorials that are gonna come your way, so that when it comes to your hoods, you can be like all confident and stuff. Here we go. There we go. Now I am going to set these with a bit more of that setting powder, because you never know what's gonna happen later. If you don't use a primer, your shadows aren't going to stay and they're going to get all stuck up in your lids and you'll have lines and all sorts of paraphernalia going on in there. You can just use a concealer and set it really well with powder and that'll make the eyeshadow colours glide over really nicely. Some primers also you don't need to use a setting powder over the top of them. This one, I definitely feel like it helps the shadows not to drag as you're applying them. You'll probably have noticed too that I didn't actually set my concealer, and that is because it is quite a thick formula and you can end up too cakey if you go and add more powder. But if you do, just push them out so that that line disappears, and you should only have to do that once and then it won't be there. As of this point here, you can see that I've corrected the colour and this area is a little bit brighter on my face, but I don't have that real heavy bright out there concealed look, which looks amazing on camera, but in real life I don't really like it. So no face is complete without beautiful brows. Just these can be big heavy brows or really thin brows or completely untouched or completely done. I happen to love them all. What I'm gonna do today is just really low maintenance, easy. All you need is the product and a brush. It's a universal color, so I use this on blonde people as well as like really really black people, and then Asians like myself. It looks like this. Put a little bit on the brush, get the excess off, and then feather it through. There we go. Eyes. For the eyes, I'm going to line the whole lot with a colour called Taupe Matte, and it is basically a nice skin tone. I find that creating a base like that first allows the other colours to go really nicely on top and blend a little bit easier. Now I'm going to use Matte Beige, which looks like that. To coat my lid and create sort of an area where it's going to be like my, I don't know, just watch. Just provides a little bit more depth to the eye without being too much of a heavy colour. See how it's softly just giving a bit of something here? It's very natural. And I'm taking it all the way over like that, right into there as well. This isn't a shimmer, so it's good for the old hoods. The moment you put something really shimmery or light on this bit so that when your eye opens and your hood overtakes, it just makes this area look so much more prominent. Now with my trusty little brush cleaner thing that I made, I'm just gonna do this and take all the excess color off so that we can use the same brush for the next color. What? Now I'm gonna take a darker brown called Matte Earth, which has a tiny bit of shimmer in it, but you can't really see it. And I'm going to put it into my little creasy area here to give a little bit of definition and make the look just that little bit more. Just in the corner there. And I'm really only concentrating it on the outer corner of my eye. You just look in the mirror, and if you feel like you can take it up a little bit higher, do it. This colour is also going to be the one that I'm going to use to take it down here to soften out my eyeliner when I use that. Just smooth it out. Now I'm going to take a colour called Sandstone, which is beautiful. Look at that. Can you see? Can you see all the sparkles? And I'm going to apply it on my lid and in the inner corner of my eye, and this will just open up, brighten the whole eye area. You don't have to have a really insane eye look to make it really stand out. Subtle can be beautiful too, just in case you can't see that. Now to very subtly define the eye a little bit more, I'm going to put a black eyeliner up in my upper lash line, just in here. Yeah. Try and keep them open so that it can dry. There's the difference. Are these songs all on repeat? Now I'm gonna take that same brown shadow from before and put it just softly underneath my bottom lash line to give my eyes a little bit more definition. Now I'm going to line my bottom lash line with some white pencil just to help bring the eye out, open it up a little bit more, brighten everything up, and create some sort of contrast between the brown shadow and my eyeball. Don't worry about it getting on your lashes, we can fix that up. While you're there, tidy up your concealer. There's the difference between the eyes so far. Look how much more this one is hooded than that one. Now I'm going to mascara myself, and before I do that I will curl my lashes. They don't really need it because they already can stick up if I push them that way and then set them with mascara. I am lucky enough that that happens, but curling them just keeps them all uniform. They all kind of stick up at the same level and go the same direction, and I feel like it's a little bit more of a polished look. Make sure you've got them all in there. You can spread them out evenly in the curler just to give them a little bit better placement. Squeeze. Pull it out slightly, squeeze again. And there we go. This is L'Oreal Telescopic Mascara. I do love it because the brush is just so tiny and it gets right in there. I like to shush it into the base of the lashes a little bit, side to side like that, and then bring it out. And then I like to just keep applying it little by little where I want a little bit more volume, which is definitely down in here. Now normally I like to do the bottom lashes first, because when you go down like this, as you do to put your mascara on, your top lashes can touch all of the sap hair and you end up getting stuff that you don't want to have to clean up. My lashes are so fine and flimsy that if they get any little bit of mascara stuck to them that then gets stuck to the next eyelash, it curls under and creates this horrible little mess. You kind of just have to not care about these things, otherwise you'll forever be frustrated at your makeup application. See? Look. Now it's all done that. Look what it's done now. Now I don't really have any major solution for this except to try putting your mascara on very carefully. I'll just tidy that bit up in there. Maybe just separate them a little bit. Look how much more this eye is open, despite this one's covered by a giant hood, but look at that! You have to be careful with applying too much mascara because you can end up just overloading it and making it too clumpy, too thick on the ends. Bear with me as I try and hope that this goes well. And if you're going to build it up anywhere, I would suggest building it up right in the base so you get that heavy drama down low as opposed to up high. Now I'm going to go ahead and do my other eye, and you can watch me do that just to recap on what I've already said. Now before I apply blush and highlighter, I'm just going to do my lips because I feel like that way I can see how the finished product is going to look and then adjust how much of this I want on, if that makes sense. Colour in the whole lip. That way as your lipstick comes off, you're not going to be left with just a telltale line. Before I put my lip gloss on, I'm just going to highlight the Widow's Peak. I'm just going to put a little bit of highlighter on this area here, which will... Ooh. Oh, heck. There it is.
And then
a nice nude lip gloss. I'm going to use the Bella V retractable lip liner pencil to put this on just for hygiene reasons. It's awesome. Look. Wait for it. Oh, yeah. Now that we've done that, it is time for blush. Oh, I love it! It has this beautiful soft sheen in it. Look, that makes your look. Luminescence. Look, guys, I'm sorry. This is so distracting. I know, I get it. Now with that, I'm going to apply some highlighter up here and here. And maybe just a bit here, just to give a bit of, or maybe not, I don't know, we'll see what happens. Oh, wait a minute. Blend. If I haven't said it already, the reason why you blend is this. See, look, there's a line there where it goes, I don't know if you can see, hang on. In the makeup world, this type of thing is looked at as non-blended, so we're going to soften that up. Even the softer looks take time. There we go. I am only putting on the tiniest bit, despite what you may think. See out in the light? Just, oh yeah, oh, oh, oh! Now I am going to do my trusty just put it here thing. Just put it there. Only because if you're going about with all this shiny beautifulness here, it makes sense that it should come up here too. But half the time when I'm doing it, I can't actually see that I've done it because my eyes, I'm not positioned in the right place to be able to. No, I can't see it. So don't make the mistake of keeping on going until you can see it, because chances are from this angle out here, they can see it all right. Maybe we'll just do some up here a little bit. Now, I will say that you do really need to be careful if you have lots of wrinkles or imperfections or things like that, of people who will actually care that you can see them when you put highlight on. If you want to wear it, just wear it. It can aid you if you have a lot of powder or shiny things on said lines and dots and things, because they're reflecting light where they are raised but creating shadow where they are not raised. Therefore you get even more texture and more lines. Whatever is there is going to be accentuated. It doesn't mean that if you do have any of those you can't have highlight or wear a different kind of look. It just means that you need to go about it the right way, and that might mean using some kind of cream highlight, something that doesn't sit on the skin. There's always things you can do that suit your age and suit your skin. But who said that we should do what suits our age or suits our skin? Just try and play and experiment. Do you know what would take this look to a whole new level? I think I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna put on eyelashes. This is okay on its own, right? Yeah? But first, green tea. Oh, with pomegranate. Oh. Ah, eyelashes. Come with me as I delve into the wonderful world of applying false eyelashes. First, shall we pray? Lord, I pray, please make this work. Normally before I put eyelashes on, I will do a nice tight little black line of liquid eyeliner right at the base of my lashes. It's not in order to create more heavy eyeliner or a wing or anything like that. It's really just to give a little bit more of a base for the lashes to sit in. Look what that did. Now, could you please get back in place? Thank you. With your lashes, you want to make sure that you have a nice pair of lashes that are easy to put on. Just kidding, there's no such thing. What you do is you need a pair of tweezers. Some people do them without tweezers. There's 50,000, 100 million, trillion videos on how to put eyelashes on, so feel free to search them. This is just how I do it, which is probably learnt from lots and lots of mistakes. These are my favourite all time, like I've salvaged these. This is probably the 10th time I've worn them. Don't tell anyone. They are Ardell Wispies and they look like this. This isn't a tutorial designed for solely putting on eyelashes, hence why there's not going to be much detail. When you apply your glue, just put a very thin strip all the way along the lashes. I like to concentrate it on the ends because it tends to, you don't want that to come off on your eye. And the trick now is waiting till the glue goes tacky. Everybody knows this, but if you're not used to lashes, this is one of the things you have to do. And then what I'm gonna do is think of all the good times that have gone by with lashes and hope that they can get me through this ordeal. Because we never know if it's gonna work or not. And then if you go and put it on your eye and it doesn't work, all the glue messes up your makeup that you've already spent hours doing. When it's your own lash, you can blow on it. Make that glue get tacky. After about 20 seconds, I'm sure it's been about 40, you go and apply it to your lid. Here we go. I make no apologies for what's about to happen. Did that really just happen? Now you can see there's one eyelash in here that is doing my head in, but it's only because I've worn these so much that they probably need to go. I just don't want to say goodbye to my babies. Well, that was surprisingly easy. Don't get your hopes up, Danny, because we've only done one and there's still another one to go. Put it on nice and gentle. I haven't worn these in a while, but I'm feeling like they're quite long. I wonder if this one's going to go as well as this one. Yeah, I can't do it. Push them down so they don't stick up so much. Come on guys, please cooperate. Okay, so we're just gonna roll with it. They're so much bigger than I remember them being. Did my eyes get smaller? Have my hoods gotten bigger? Have my tastes simply changed? To compensate for all of this, I'm gonna go and put some more black eyeliner. I mean, some more mascara. See, look, I don't know what's happening. I'm in a mess. So much has happened since we last addressed the issue, so I'm just going to apply a little bit more white eyeliner in here. Touch up! Ooh, finished! Just kidding. I'm just going to go and fix it. Finally, we've come to the end. Thank you so much, guys. I hope you liked my video and the videos to come. If you do, please subscribe because then you'll be right in there with me and you'll know. And it makes me look good. I will list everything down below in the description box. So if you want to know what any of the products were that I used, just have a look down there. And otherwise, if you have any questions, please fire away. Likewise, if you live in the area and want to come and see me for a makeup, by all means, make an appointment and do that. Remember, there's no right or wrong way. Just continue to experiment and try different things. I'll list all my social media sites down below. Snapchat's another one if you want to see some day-to-day antics with me. Sometimes my nails are going to be awesome. What are you doing? You got to start somewhere, right?